Yes, good afternoon, Simon. What a day for AFC Bournemouth fans. They've been waiting patiently for a number of months now, but we've had confirmation in the last few moments that the takeover of the football club has been rubber-stamped by the Premier League, and AFC Bournemouth now have new owners led by Bill Foley, the Las Vegas-based businessman and philanthropist who is now owning this football club behind me. We've had a statement that's just dropped in the last couple of seconds. I'll read you the first few lines because it is quite fascinating and quite clearly the start of an exciting era for this football club. But it reads, AFC Bournemouth can confirm that owner Maxim Demin has sold his 100% stake in the club to Black Knight Football Club, of which Bill Foley is the managing general partner, with a number of limited partners, including a 50.1% interest. It goes on to say, Bill had attended the Cherries' victory over Leicester City in October ahead of completing the deal, which has now been ratified by the Premier League. It's our understanding this deal is worth in excess of £100 million. So a really significant day for Bournemouth fans and for this football club. They currently sit 14th in the Premier League, but knowing what I do know about Bill Foley in the last few months, he is a hugely ambitious man and will be having hugely ambitious plans for this football club. He is 78 years old tomorrow, so this is an early birthday present for the new Bournemouth owner.
And Mark, before we throw things forward to how life might look for Bournemouth under their new owners, let's just quickly reflect on the now former owner, Maxim Demin. How is he going to be remembered by the club?
Well, quite simply, Maxim Demin will go down as the greatest owner of this football club's history. He's been absolutely superb. He's not done a single media interview whilst being the owner for around 11 years, which gives you an indication as to kind of his personality. Very humble, very hardworking, a very generous man as well, who has invested so much money into this football club over the course of the last 11 years. He first came in back in 2011 and was a huge part of the boardroom and the club that went from League One to the Premier League and stayed there for 5 years. He's invested over £250 million in that time. He supported the club when they got relegated from the Premier League after 5 seasons. And he's always continually done the very best. He's tried to build things off the football club, away from the pitch as well as on the pitch. He's developed the club financially. He's invested in the infrastructure. He was key to starting the training ground work that is being done at the moment as well. And as someone that has always had the club's interests at his very heart, he's a very friendly, decent guy. On the two or three opportunities I've had the chance to spend time with him and meet him, he's always been hugely passionate about what he does and this football club, and has taken this club to a new era. When you speak to Bournemouth fans 11 years ago, they would have never dreamt of even really getting to the Championship. That was the dream. But Maxim Demin was someone that said, no, I'm going to take that dream and I'm going to multiply it by 1,000. That's what he did, and he was true to his word. So he'll go down without question as someone that was hugely important for this football club, and will be known as the greatest ever owner that brought things to the fans that they couldn't even dream of.
Scenes being at the Vitality Stadium doing a live game for Sky, the first time they won promotion, and seeing him celebrating up in the director's box. So let's throw things forward now, Mark. And one of the new American owners is rather famous. Tell us a little bit about him.
Yes, this is quite amazing, really, and it shows the direction of this football club. The Hollywood A-lister, the Hollywood actor Michael B. Jordan, is now a part owner of Premier League AFC Bournemouth. That's been confirmed in the statement as well. And he talks a little bit about the excitement of this. But I think this gives you an indication as to Bill Foley's plans, what he'd like to do with the football club, the direction he'd like to take it in, and the fact that he's got a little bit of Hollywood stardust now attached to the football club as well. Michael B. Jordan will be known to our viewers as someone that starred in Black Panther and Creed, amongst various other movies as well. And this is the first opportunity for him himself to go into sports ownership. So this is a new venture for him. He's only 35 years old, so he's got a lot of time left to inject enthusiasm into this football club behind us as well. But this is a huge moment. I think that gives you an indication as to Bill Foley's plans, the type of plans that the football club has, and the fact that they have someone like Michael B. Jordan a part of their new ownership consortium. It gives you an indication as to the type of club this is going to be moving forward.
And I'm sure the fans will love a little bit of stardust amongst the owners, but what they'll be most interested in is what is the vision for the club of these new owners? I mean, with the January transfer window not too far away, what might the fans expect in terms of new signings arriving at the club?
Yeah, well, it's quite clear you don't buy a football club for in excess of £100 million if you're not planning to invest in it, inject money and try and take it to the next level. So it's clear there are some hugely ambitious, exciting plans for Bill Foley and his consortium team as well. So this is going to be really exciting. He does make reference to this in the statement that's dropped in the last few moments as well. He talks about the investment into the team. So clearly that means there'll be new faces coming in January. It means that there'll be work done on the stadium behind us. We know that Maxim Demir was instrumental in starting the training ground work as well, so we know that that is going to be continued by Bill Foley. The investment in the new training ground, which is going to be state of the art, is also going to be there. The statement also makes reference to the community as well. He wants to continue to build and invest in the local community. He wants to spend money on the academy and take that from its current category status forward as well, and he also wants to invest in the women's side as well. So he's making all the right noises, saying all the right things, and I think if you're a Bournemouth fan right now, looking at this situation and looking at this statement, you'll be hugely excited for the future of this football club. It's the start of a new era, and quite simply, it seems like it could be the start of the most exciting era in the club's history.